guys, Wiser here, bringing you the recap of the last war for 2.0. It was the arranged matchup between WarWhales, and it was a fantastic war. Hats off to WarWhales. They did come away with a victory. Honestly, it was just one of those photo finish wars, you know, fight to the finish, back and forth score kind of thing. It's just unbelievable. Absolutely amazing time. Good job by both sides. Flip over here and check it out. 85-84 for WarWhales. Obviously 60-60 attacks on both sides. This 1 3-star on Dito was the difference. So you can see the whales cleared the nines all the way down. So good for them. Good job. And 2 stars on all the 10s for 2.0 and cleared the 9. So fantastic job, guys. Fantastic war for both sides. This is really what the fair play community thrives for. Just absolutely amazing content. I wish I could show you every replay in this war, but obviously that's just not conceivable. So I do have, this is going to be a bit of a long recap, so we're just going to jump right into some of these replays here. Like I said, I wish I could show all of them. There's some really good ones. Sorry if I skipped your attack and you thought it was awesome, because it probably was. There was just too much good stuff for me to choose from, so I just kind of picked what I thought were my favorites. I'm going to start here with Sean's hit on Tomatoes, number 11. Sean brings a little drag swap here. You see he drops a minion and then a wizard, I believe, over here. Just kind of starts creating his funnel ahead of time, so good job with that. Just really counted his tiles, knew these units were going to be safe. He does drop the drag swap first. For some reason, I thought he went in with a shattered entry there. So drag swap's looking good, though. Obviously, those dragons are going to go right in on that queen as soon as that barracks down. He knows it's good. He goes ahead and sends in the golems. Really gets a spread on this one to make sure it locks onto that corner. He wants to be able to create that funnel. I liked how that test wall breaker went in and popped the Tesla. Now he is safe to send in the rest of them. Because I don't know if you guys knew this, but the range on the trigger, so the range for you to step into the range of the Tesla and have it come out of the ground is shorter than its actual attack range. So once it's popped up, it will attack at a further distance. But everything's going good. He's really taking out these 4 Teslas with this kill squad, which is huge value. He's going to take out this whole area. Gets the jump down for the golems and the king. King hops in. Really, at this point, you look, he's got 2 heals, 21 hogs, still a balloon as well. Queen is dead. CC is now taken care of. And all these defenses are still going down. His heroes are still full health. Has rage still on his queen. Looking good. Goes ahead and sends in the hawks. Sends in a pack. I think it's about 8 or 10. Really, he's just going to kind of work his way through this base. Single triggers these bombs. So that's a great job with that. Great read on that. Hogs are going to go nowhere but straight through that. So fantastic job triggering that one at a time. And just sprinkles them in. And if you look, there's not a heck of a lot of this base remaining. More hogs going in on these point defense in the queen chamber that was taken out by the drag swap. Just looking pretty at this point. One more heal is going to go down over this crossbow. There it is. Looking good. Handful of defenses remaining for all these hogs. His queen is still doing cleanup on the bottom. He's got a wizard doing cleanup. And right as these hogs getting in range, I think he drops one more wizard remaining to clean up from this side as well. So good job of getting those cleanup troops down. Really, it's just a matter of your hogs getting back to this cannon, staying alive from those skeletons. They don't stand a chance. They're trying. They're beating on them. No chance for the skellies. Cannon goes down. They turn around. Skeletons are dead. Hogs are now on cleanup. Sorry about that, guys. And we're on cleanup mode. Nice job, Sean. Sexy, sexy attack. That is your 3. Beautiful. Right. One more down. Chief Jimbo here. Zerd's had a 6-star war, both fresh hits. Planned his attacks on Twidla. I was kind of got to be part of a little bit of that, and he had some serious success this war. Great job, Zerds. He's down in Swarm doing work for us. Came up to do this arranged war. Awesome job this war, man. So he just goes ahead, he sends in a shattered entry. He actually has a 3rd golem, though, so I should say stone in the bag. Where did that golem go? You just dropped it. Am I blind? There it is. So Golem goes in. Sorry about that, guys. But notice he brings 4 Valkyries here as well. He's got Earthquake spell that's going to open all of this base up. Once he opens all of this base up, he's going to just let those Valks just parade in. His goal is to get all the way to this queen. So that's why he brings three golems here with the four Valks. Like, that's just an insane amount of tanking, but he needs it. If he wants to get to that queen, that's what he needs. So here come the Valks. Watch these Valks as they go in here, right? This gold storage goes down. They're going to take a step up. As soon as they get into this range, that queen locks on. And watch these Valks. Look at them go. Soon as that queen attacks, boom, right over to the queen. Taking her down, couple swipes, queen is toast. He sends in a few balloons on this back end. Really, everything's just looking great at this point. Keep in mind, there are no air defenses alive. He got all the air defenses with those Valks in that kill squad. Just huge, huge value in that huge stretch of the kill squad. So he's going to send in a couple loons on every defense on the outside here. He's got this king full health over here doing serious work. A huge pack of balloons. Too much for that Tesla to handle. Really, everything is looking good at this point. This is definitely going to be a three-star hit. God, I should really turn off Skype, guys. Sorry about that. Usually do, actually, but it's caught me a couple times. But yeah, still got two. There's nothing that can kill these balloons left on the map. He's got cleanup all over the place. Beautiful attack surge, sexy war. He just killed it. Like how the wizards were in range of that town hall. Balloons get on over to this builder's hut and elixir storage. It is GG. Three stars. Nice job, Zerds. All right, go down the map a bit here. 21, Oki. Oki brings a beautiful, beautiful attack here. So notice this kind of strange army comp. Goes cold-blooded with four Valks, but the Valks don't go in here. So just goes cold-blooded here. His goal here with this little part is to get the CC and these two air defense. So wall gets opened up. This golem does serious work here with this queen. Queen backs it up. A couple wizards in there really just creating the funnel, and the queen is going to do the rest. So CC troops come out, drops a poison, perfect place for that. Queen's just got to take down this gold storage, drops the rage for the queen, just great job getting the queen right on the edge of that rage. I've talked about that before. Queen's just going to rip through these CC troops. Boom, down goes the loons. Dragon is dying very fast. One wizard gets in there to help out with that air defense. Queen gets locked onto that next air defense. Sexy. All right, so here is the second prong of the attack. Drops the king, just creates a bit of a leeway. Going to drop the Valks to keep the king going forward. And these Valks get sucked right in onto that queen. Boom, queen is going down. King rages it up, takes a little part of this base. And guess what? Three lava hounds and whatever it was, I think 16 balloons for these two air defense and the rest of this base. So really doesn't stand a chance at this point. Drops the rages for these balloons. They're going to be on top of these defenses like nothing. And there's really nothing left of this base. There's a sweeper and archer tower. Once they get through these two compartments, that's it. That is it. It is basically cleanup. That archer tower is going down. Cannon is down. Last defense is going down. Doesn't get that hound to burst. Oh, I forgot about this section. Sorry, I should have zoomed out. But regardless, way too much for this base. Three balloons saved in the bag for cleanup. Oki, beautiful attack. Just a beautiful attack. Really like that one. Let's move down to 24. Coloman brings a great attack here with these 10 Valks. I'm a sucker for these redheads. I think everyone is. Goes ahead and drops the shattered entry, creates his funnel. Gonna just kind of open all this up. Wallbreaker goes in. It is good. So he's gonna send in the rest here. Opens up this wall. He's gonna let the golems go in. Just do the work. Really large funnel. Good patience on the Valks. Wizard Tower is gonna go down. And down go the Valks. The one test Valk, I really like that because you don't want to drop all your Valks and have them go the wrong way. That would be horrible. But all these Valks, the Valk Parade goes in. King goes in behind it. Just look at how much of this base these 10 Valks are just going to shred through. So the queen's going to lock them on. The Valks love just sucking right into that queen. Boom, she's going down in like a couple hits. Queen is down. They lock onto the king. King's going down here. He sends in a few hogs on this Tesla. Great timing on that. Wizard backing it up. Cleanup wizard already in effect now. Hogs just sprinkling in on this base. I've had quite a few of these attacks. Usually I'll use the double jump. Whether if you want to know whether you should use earthquake or double jump, it just depends on the base. If you can get this much with the earthquake, opt for the earthquake. It's the safer option because it's always there, first of all. So if the Valks end up over here and try and come back, it's still going to be open. The jump's not going to be down. As well, it is wider than the jump. So they just get more of this base. But with a double jump, it would be when you want to jump over two compartments that don't connect with the earthquake. Sometimes you got to do that. So really, it sends all the rest of the hogs in these defenses. And I've had many of these Valkyries go like this for me, where your hogs don't even end up killing all the defenses. But what ends up happening is the king is just protected by this slew of Valks up here, and is just a bodyguard for this king. And it's just, there's nothing that can take this down. The hogs end up thinning out the defenses so much that it's not enough. The Valks end up cleaning up. As long as time is not an issue, there's just nothing that can kill these Valks. The only times that I've had these raids not really succeed for me is when I run out of time, because the Valks are running around, they got to go through walls. So you can see, I bet he almost gets caught on time. I'm not 100% sure on this raid because of that elixir storage in there. He's kind of lucky that Wiz gets in there and takes it out. But as you can see, it is clean up. Valks beat through the wall. The Wiz is on the elixir storage. It is a 3-star. Nice job, Coleman. What else did I have? 25. Craze. I like Craze's attack here because not often you see 4 witches being utilized in a TH9 3-star attempt. I thought this was very clever. Huge piece of the base open. And he's going to get quite a bit of splash damage on entry here. And once that wizard tower goes down, there's no more splash damage in that area of the base. So he goes in and lets the golems and heroes kind of work their way in, drops the witches and gets the skellies going. Gets really good tanking for the CC troops. Poison goes down, so they're not doing much. Really, they're going to go down super quickly. Lets the king go in behind. King hasn't been touched yet. So, again, this whole base is open now because of these earthquakes. Just really good placement on those. Really good reads on what you can get. And the witches just go to town here. I believe 3 of the witches last the entire raid, which if you think they were dropped fairly early, that is huge, huge value. So, again, like I said, not often that you get to really experience 4 witches in a TH9 3-star attempt. So really clever attack here. Goes ahead and drops these hogs in from the 6 o'clock location. Gets an early heal down for them. You're going to get huge value. Taking out all these defenses. I don't think he's even lost one hog yet. Tesla's going to go down super quickly. Still has 4 more hogs to reinforce on this back end. Witches are still going to town. Look at them doing town work in this core. Just fantastic value. Still has the ability on the queen. Got a cleanup Wiz on the outside already before he even sends in those last 4 hogs. There they go to reinforce on that cannon. Great, great value on all of your troops here, Craze. Just a beautiful attack. Sends in the wall breakers. Do a little bit of tank, and they took 1 hit from those from that archer tower for you. Cogs are on cleanup. Just shredded this base. Three out of the 4 witches are still alive at the end of this raid. That's just blew my mind. Excellent, excellent attack, Craze. All right, I got one more here. This is already a bit of a lengthy video, but I had to show this one. Rob, sexy, sexy attack from the old co-leader in Swarm, who recently got moved up to Core and Invicta. So congrats, man. That is awesome. And he was called up to fill some weight in this 2.0 war. So he goes ahead and sends in, I think it's about 8 hogs in this top section. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, something like that. With the heal. And now look what the value he gets out of this heal and hogs. It's a CC pulled out and takes out a double giant bomb. Just like that. So great value on that entry with the hogs there, Rob. Drops the poison. Goes ahead and takes it out. Does miss 1 balloon, but no big deal on that. Just going to wait this poison out till the balloons go down. And that Valk as well. He doesn't want anything hurting his golems. He really needs his golems to survive as long as possible here. So as soon as the Valk goes down, there goes his golems going and shatter down over near this queen chamber. Just basically going to start creating his funnel with all of these wizards. So looking good so far. Not sure. I think this was a cleanup attack, but there's a bunch of Teslas in here, and he's really just trying to slowly kind of work his way into that queen chamber and then drop his king and just like bite like a snake, take that king down or queen down. So as you can see, the Teslas popping up, another one's going to pop in a second, just roast this golem. There's a third one. So it is a deadly, deadly little queen chamber section here, but it's just enough time for that king to get in there. Keep in mind, Rob only has 16 heroes, guys, and this is a pretty maxed out. I mean, level 2 crossbows, couple town hall 8 point defenses, but you know, this is not by any means a joke of a base. So Rob goes ahead and he swaps the queen for the king there. This queen takes down the Teslas all on her own, and then sits there and beats on a wall for, I think, the rest of the raid. But he sent in his hogs at all different angles here. Basically, a few per defense. Really just wants to take it down all these compartments. He has one heal where they're all kind of meeting up. Great heal placement on that there, Rob. Once this crossbow and Tesla go down, really all that's left is this queen chamber. And like I had said, this queen's been standing in this little section while the crossbow's been locked onto the stuff in the middle for the whole raid now. So she's taking down the dark elixir storage, all those Teslas, now the town hall. She's going to start working on a wall there while the hogs roll in here and take out the last couple remaining defenses. It is cleanup time. Rob absolutely smoked it. Nice job, buddy. Congrats on Core and Invicta. No, they are glad to have you there, because you are a beast doing this with 16 heroes. Yes, guys, it can be done. You do not need max heroes to 3-star these bases. So, tough war again. Didn't go in 2.0's favor. I know. Obviously, that's what you want. You want the victory, but there is a little piece of some joy you get from having a war like this. Because really, this is what the fair play community just looks for, and this is how we have fun. This is what the competitive edge that we look for when we're playing this game. And if we could avoid farming wars that just kind of, you don't learn a lot and are sort of boring and you just roll over a lot of the bases, well, that's not fun, right? Like, we want to match up against these types of clans where we have these photo finish wars. You know, it's a fight to the finish. And both sides just have an awesome time, because they're planning, their strategy, not only with how you attack the bases, but which bases you attack. There is an overall strategy that comes from the clans, too, that you actually have to execute, unlike a farming war where everyone just kind of picks a target and goes. So I'll leave it there. It's already a very long video. Good job 2.0 in the overall sense. It just fell just short. So that should about do it for your Wisdom from Wiser here, guys. Just trying to help you guys bag that next 3-star. And until then, I'm out.